Students, can you see the screen? Is it visible? Yeah, somebody give me an answer. Shimash, can you see the screen? Yes? Jessica? Yeah, okay, fine. You can see the screen. Now we're going to start with the revision of the chapters that we have done in this term. And today we discuss a letter to God. And as many of you were saying right now, this is a very nice chapter. And yes, we are completely in awe of Lencho. I am not just going to revise here because I think so, you know, like I'll just tell the summary because you people think that, okay, fine, revision means that, okay, ma'am is just going to speak and she's going to tell us the summary and we just have to just sit here and listen. So can I just get a response from you all as students at home also? You can raise your hand, turn on your video, and you can also participate in the discussion. No, I can't unmute all of you. There'll be a chaos in the classroom. Since when? Yeah. So if you want to answer, please raise your hand and I will unmute you. Okay? Right? So you can also participate in the discussion. Now, let us do this in a sequential manner. Can anybody... Let's just, what were the sequence of events that led to Lencho to write a letter to God, right? So where did Lencho live? Yes, so at the top of the, right, and you could see the valley from there. And what did Lencho do? He was a farmer. And yes, what... was he happy with his crops? So, of course, they were there. It was a good crop till now, and he was just waiting. Jasleen, turn on your video, and then you can answer. Turn on your video. I know you're one of the best students, but rules are rules. So, Jasleen is going to turn on the video, and she's going to give me an answer. Yes, Jasleen, you can unmute yourself.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Good morning. Yeah, Jasleen, can you tell me what were the events that led to Lencho writing a letter to God? Let us do them stepwise and we can, yeah, you can lower your hand also. Yeah, let's start. And we'll continue in sequence. You speak 2-3 ways. Next, the other student can pick up. Right?
Ma'am, firstly, the when Lencho was living there, he saw the field from his house that was fully ripened with the corn dotted with the flowers. Okay. And he was...
So he saw his crop, right? Then?
He thought that he would have a good harvest this year. Yes. But the only thing but he wanted was a good downpour or a shower.
Yeah, good showers he wanted. Did the showers come? Okay, thank you, Jasleen. Let's hear it from somebody else. You can mute yourself now. Thank you very much. Yes, next one, who's going to speak? Yes, next. Harshit, would like to give the answer? I can unmute you. Yes, where's Nishtha? Okay, fine. So you want to speak, please raise your hand and I will unmute you. Now, meanwhile, the students who are in the class, can you tell me what happened next? Tell me what happened next. Then the showers came. Yes. What all happened? There were only showers or what else came? Oh, the rain came, there was hail. And of course, what he compared the rain there falling as to? With coins, right? That he is going to get so much of money. But then those too much of coins, they fell and they caused a lot of destruction. The problem was when this rain turned into hail, right? And what happened to his crop? What happened to his crop? It was destroyed. And why did he say that it was even worse than a locust attack? Why was it worse than a locust? Yes, Vansh, very nice. Every crop? Oh, you're Dhruv, sorry. Your Vansh. Okay, see? Right, yeah, yeah. Okay, I like you both look similar. Right. Yes, Hardik, wake up. Yes, then what happened, Dhruv? All the? Yes, so the field was cleared off all the crop. Let us reframe the sentence, okay? And yes, so what was Lentu's feeling, Bhavan? Tell me. What was his feelings there? Imagine you are Lencho and it's been raining and such a terrible thunderstorm and hailstones falling and your crop has been. What would your feeling be as a farmer? Yeah, of course, disappointment. Absolute disappointment. It's a sense of loss. It's disappointment because the farmer is there dependent on the rain for a good harvest. And right in front of his eyes, like it's been destroyed. What are locusts? What are locusts? So these are insects which attack the crop. And they come in a huge swarm and they just, you know, like, of course, attack the standing crop. And then after some time, they just fly away. But here he's saying that a locust attack would have left some flowers on his field, right? Or on his crop. But the hail destroyed everything. Now, what did his future look like now? What did he think about his future now? Yeah. So he was afraid that his family would go hungry, right? So what did he think about? What was the common belief among them, right? Let us think about here. Yes, what is the common belief? You will not come to class unprepared. So today we will go home and read the lesson. And of course, we will be continuing with this tomorrow also. I don't want blank faces. And I don't want blank screens also. Yes. So he decided to ask help from God. But of course, there was a popular saying that no one goes hungry. So God is going to feed every stomach. And he thought, and who's going to feed my family for the whole year? They didn't have money. They didn't have enough money for even for the seeds, right? Everything had been destroyed. So now all his hopes are on God. Okay. Now, so he decides to write a letter to God. Yes. Where does he go? Okay. He goes to the post office. He writes a letter there. Right, he's written a letter. What does he do? He drops his letter over there. What is so strange about his letter that the postmaster has to take a look at it? Oh my, why are we speaking like this all together? Can you speak one at a time? Yes, we can. Yeah, who has not spoken? Now it is Vansh's turn. Yes. So why would was the postmaster so curious to see what he has written? What did he find over there written on the envelope? Because it was written to God, yes. And in the letter, what had he asked for? 100 pesos. He's asked for 100 pesos, right? Why only 100? Like, yeah, he's asked only for 100. He could have said, I need 200. 100 I'll keep for my, you know, crops and all, and 100 I'll keep for a better future. Yes, well, because what is reflected from this quality, you know, like he's just asked, he was not greedy. Very nice, very nice. So he's an honest person, right? And of course, was he greedy? No, he was not greedy. Right, so he was there, no, and he believed I need just enough money to pass this time, and then after that, things will be better when I'll have my own crops. Right, so he will be able to take care of his family. Okay, right, what about the way in which the letter was written? It was an informal letter, yeah. Well, it was an informal letter. What else was there about the letter? The address was incorrect. Okay. Now, what other, what else do we learn about Lencho, right? From the way he has written the letter about the contents, we know he is honest, he's not greedy. What else do we know? His address is, he is not very educated, okay? He is not highly educated, not, yes, educated enough. He's literate, but he's not had a very, you can say, a high education, right? He's very innocent. What has he asked? He's asked for 100 pesos. He is quite innocent, right? And of course, who had read the letter? Postmaster had read the letter. And what was there that really impressed the postmaster? His innocence and his faith in God. Absolutely, right. Now, what did the postmaster decide to do? To help him. Okay. Now, this thought has come to the postmaster's mind. So, like, suppose he's in the office. Okay, Amritpal, please stand up. So, let's make Amritpal the postmaster. And Mehul is one of the employees. Right? Please stand up. Right. So, Amritpal is going to tell, or rather, the postmaster is going to tell the other employees what he has decided. Right? Yeah, it can be a very informal dialogue, and yes, so let's, yeah, otherwise we don't, but now when I've asked you, then you think of, where did I leave my mask? Here it is, yes. Right? Yeah, someone, come on, speak loud. The dialogue, can you recreate the dialogue between the postmaster and the employees? He's one of the employees, he's working. You're the boss, you're the postmaster. We are telling him your decision. Okay, you've read the letter. Then do that. Let's say you're laughing. Okay, Amritpal is laughing after he's read the letter. Then what is he going to do next? I can have two of the students at home also. You can do this interaction. Can you speak in English? Tell this to him. Tell this to him. No, he's not heard it. Did we hear? No, we have not heard. Speak up. Speak up. Speak up. You want to come here and speak? You want to come here? No, you don't want. Okay, stand there and speak. Come on, it's so easy. Done. Okay, very nice. Very bad conversation you had. Let's have a better conversation. Yes, Namit, get up. And Imani. Yes, come on. You are the postmaster. You are one of the employees. Yeah, I tell him. Yeah, only one employee. Or we can have everybody as you. Okay, you stand up and you're dressing the class. Tell them. Okay, I made this decision. Namit, what will you say? You don't know what you're going to say? Yeah, good. Jaya? You call them employees? Yeah, friends, dear friends. Very nice, very good. Yes, very nice, very good. So at least this is what the postmaster would have said, would have thought when he read the letter, okay? Right? The thing is, we people talk so much, but when I give you something formal to do, oh my God, we don't know how to speak. Ma'am, we don't know any language. We want to go hide somewhere, right? Under the bench, under the chair, and don't even look at us. What's happened to your confidence? So I'm going to revise like this only. Be ready. Well, tomorrow you might be Nelson Mandela. So be ready. Okay? Right? Fine? Okay. Now let us have Lencho's reaction. Shantanu, Lencho has got his letter. He opens the letter. What does he see and what is his reaction? Yes. No, all of you give me your money. He does not know they have given the money. He does not know that he has. Yes, so he's decided to write a letter again. Very nice. Very good. Sit down. Yes, so he writes that in the letter. So what about the second letter? Writes again. Yes. Simon? What happens? Why does he have to write a second letter also? Yes. Very nice, very nice. So he says that they are a bunch of crooks, and next time you don't have to, make sure that I get all the money. You must have sent 100, but these people have. Imagine, like, of course, you're the postmaster. You had put up this initiative. Jaya, once again, please stand up. She had asked everybody to contribute, right? And instead of, Lencho writing a letter of thanks to God, he is once again so blunt and honest, right? That he does not even bother, who am I writing a letter for? We thank God. Thank you, God. I was at least something you have given me, isn't it? Like we start here after exams, we think about, 95-96%. But then after time passes, and then we look at our question papers again, and oh my God, I did something wrong. Then it comes down to 90. And with passage of time, we're happy. Oh God, I wish I get 80% only. Isn't it? And if you get 88, it's a bonus. Oh my God, I'm so clever and I'm so happy. Isn't it? So we thank God first. Isn't it? Immediately, it's like, thank God. I got this much. Right? So here, what about Lencho? Shouldn't you think he should have written at least, thank you, God. You've given me 70 pesos. But what is there about this man that we really love, we really admire a quality about Lencho? What is it? Is it his honesty? Is it his innocence? Or is it his blind faith? Yes, he has faith in God. And why do you think he did not turn to the officials? He could have gone to the officials. This is my problem. He could have pursued them, asked for, compensation and all. Why didn't he ask the officials? Yes, at home, who's going to tell me? Anybody? Why he didn't turn to the officials? Harshit? Tejveer? Dhruv? Gupta? Vishesh? Yes? Why he didn't turn to the officials? Raghav? Officials also, he thought them as a bunch of crooks, is it? Maybe he does not have faith with the authority, right? So he thinks that they are not going to help him out of this situation. And right. Okay, so he thinks that only God can help him. Right. Do you think a blind faith is good for us? We should have faith, but not blind faith. And when we have faith, should we stop working?
No.
Right, fine. I have a one-on-one connection with God and I know I'm going to get good marks. No need for me to study. Is it? We have to put in efforts. So without efforts, we are not going to get results, right? And of course, here, Lencho, do you think he was putting in efforts in the meanwhile? Do you think he was taking care of his fields and he was making sure that should get them ready for the next harvest? He was doing nothing? No, he was just sitting and waiting for the money to come. But considering how hardworking he was, what has been described about? There have been certain... Naturally, he was like, of course, the thing was that maybe, once again, preparing his fields for the next crop, he could have done that. Yep. But then he did not have seeds also, money for seeds also. He needed that, right? And of course, in the meantime, he was there waiting, right? Yes. What about the message here? At the end of the chapter, we have read this term, a bunch of crooks. Who writes it? Who writes this? And who reads it?
Postmaster.
Who had helped Lencho? Postmaster and the post office people over there, right? So the postmaster and his people, they had helped him. What would he have felt? This is what reward I get. He would have been disappointed, angry, hurt. What?
Hurt.
He would have been hurt, isn't it right? And here, Lencho does not know these people have it, right? But yes, the postmaster has put in efforts. I have discussed with you a device called. So what is so ironical about the ending? What is ironical about the ending? So it writes when things that you expect, right, they are absolutely opposite of that happens. You get something, a strange twist happens. So we were expecting Lencho to write a letter of thanks to God, and at least you send me 70 pesos, and now I'll be able to manage and maybe pass the year and the tough times that I'm going through. But he is not happy. And in fact, he blames the post office. He thinks that if I got 70, I could have got 100 also. Right? So this is, yes, so he does talk about that, right? Yes. Now, because we have read this chapter earlier, we have discussed it, and right, being the first chapter also, we do spend a lot of time on it. So I'll just ask you a few meanings. Let's see here. Come on, if you look at the chapter here. Lencho had predicted big drops of rain began to fall. In the northeast, huge mountains of clouds could be seen approaching. Huge mountains of clouds. What is the device used here? What do the mountains look like? Huge mountains. Sorry, the clouds, they look like huge mountains. What do we call this device over here? So it is not necessary you use your devices in poetry, in prose also. Huge mountains of clouds. Are the clouds like mountains or the clouds as mountains? The clouds are, yes, it's a metaphor. The clouds are mountains, right? So they're so big and huge. And of course, Lencho was happy to see those clouds. Yes. So it's a metaphor over here, right? What does predict mean? Yes. What other things do we predict? What do we predict? Other things that we predict. Yes. The things that we predict? About the weather. Okay. You do predict. Yeah. We might have rainfall today, or it might be bright and sunny tomorrow. A prediction. Yes. So like, of course, you've been watching a lot of sports also. So before the match starts, do you guess the predict the winner? Yes, we do that. Yeah. So at the end of competitions, you know, so we do that. So prediction day, try to you guess what could be the outcome, right? So like here, of course, sometimes we're very sure, and sometimes we might not be so correct. So Lencho was, his prediction was correct, right? Now look at it here. These aren't raindrops falling from the sky. They are new coins. The big drops are 10 cent pieces and the little ones are 5. What does he compare the raindrops with? With coins. And why does he compare them with coins? Because he will get it is like signaling a good harvest. Do you think Lencho was greedy? The way he was counting or the way he was looking at the rain as coins, do you think he was greedy? Was he greedy? Then why the coins? Why is he counting the money? He was predicting about his bright future. Very good answer. Absolutely correct. So he's looking at the rain and he's, happy that it is falling on his crop, on its field, and it will bring along with it what? Happiness, prosperity, good times, right? And that is there at the end of the year. Can you name a few harvest festivals of our country? Yes, Vaisakhi is a harvest festival. Onam is there. Pongal is there. Bihu is there, right? So we have many festivals which are related with harvest season. And of course, it shows that how, in our culture and traditions there, the farmers celebrating that every... Now when we read about Lencho, now we read that, yes, why farmers celebrate the safe homecoming or the safe bringing of the crops, right? Or the harvest has come home dry without any problem, safe, right? Until it does not come home safe and dry, the farmers are always worried and tense, okay? So I think so. We'll end here today. We continue tomorrow. Let me see if I'm able to, discuss multiple choice questions with you. So I'll be sharing with you multiple choice questions. Okay. Right.